Hey guys, welcome back to another episode. This is a different episode than normal. You can see I have a Stingray bicycle frame. I am currently putting it together right now. I've been talking about it with Just Rice Racing for a while that I wanted to put a motor on it. So, probably months later, I finally got myself one. However, you can probably tell from the title of the video, it didn't work. And that's because I use a 1979 Briggs Stratton, which did have to do some modifications, and it did work for the time being. However, it didn't last all the way through till the end of the project. So this is a quick little video of the whole struggle I went through to get this project to go. I will make another video and update on this bike. So if you guys want more of that, just leave comments down below, and I'll talk to you guys later. Finally got a part. This cover did not want to come off the shaft, and I had to cut it and trim it down so it could slide off. I don't know why it was getting seized up so bad, but it was. It was seizing up. No one in the forums helped me, so I ended up having to cut this down, trimming it. So probably gonna cut it off completely. Got the cam gear out with the push rods. Got the crank pulley. This is the governor, which I'm gonna replace. I'm gonna have to weld a piece to this in order to get the oil scoop right. Leaving the crank in here, just gonna sand it down real quick, clean it up. Gonna hone the cylinders, gonna sand down the piston a little bit. You can see there's a lot of dirt in there. So it's still good though. Piston rings are good, has compression. So I'm gonna go ahead and take the exhaust off and start cleaning it up, start sanding it down, and get to it. Okay, so piston rod, the piston is all in. The oil pickup or the little flinger is on there. This is so it flings oil up and around. I got the push rods back in. You can see that's the exhaust valve. Oiled it up. Did hone the cylinders. I got the cams already in lubricated. I'm gonna go ahead and stick this back in there. Like so. So when you go ahead and rotate it, it should rotate, but so that's in. I gotta line, I gotta do the timing, so I gotta line this up with the gears. So I gotta turn. So now this goes on. That will hopefully line up, which it does not. So the timing's now done. You get that mark there. You got the mark on the cam gear here. So that's in place and ready to go. Just put the starting mechanism back on just to see what it cranks over, but it's done. It's completely seized up. I can't get it to fucking crank over with the stupid belt housing on here. So, either I'm gonna have to get a new one, or I'm gonna have to get a whole new motor. So, yeah. That fucking sucks. Fucking 2 weeks. It's almost 2 weeks of work. Just to find out the motor's not gonna work.
Okay guys, so as you saw, the motor kind of seized up on me. I'm gonna do what I can to try and get a new motor or a rebuild kit for the Spriggs and Stratton, but for the time being I'm just gonna try and get the bike frame at least 90% done, so when I do get a new motor or a rebuild kit I can just slap it on and get it going. Minus I do need a belt and pulleys, but other than that, that's pretty much it for this video, and I'll see you guys next time.